What's up, guys? I'm the one and only Maverick, back with more Mass Effect Andromeda. We're gonna jump in. We're on the Nexus, so we're gonna see. Well, we're gonna check things out and see what all we're gonna be doing on there. Unlock room and decryption. Oh, yeah, I remember that. Never mind. I forgot that was for a second there. Starting off, I guess, from there.
As sleepers wake from stasis, the initiative returns.
Alright, let's see here. Looks like over here. Scourge, and things could be better as far as space travel in Andromeda. Might even be able to set up some mass relays around the place.
Please address concerns first with Director Addison. One must obey protocol.
Okay. So do I talk to Addison first then?
You've shaken things up, Pathfinder. My department actually has colonial affairs to direct. And you have new tools to help grow the initiative. AVP, ready for spending.
Sam said there was new functionality to discuss.
It's how the initiative was designed to support the Pathfinder. You and your team are out there making Andromeda viable. That empowers all of us. Hit a threshold. A new cryo group can be brought out. Want more focus on research, like on Prodromos? That's your call. Brekka will introduce the interface and handle minutia. All you need to do is decide what life in Andromeda means. No pressure.
Alright. Now can I talk to Brekka?
Hello, Pathfinder. I am Cryo Deployment Administrator Vladimir Brekka, C-63 Galati. Your first task is to decide irrevocably the course of every life in the initiative.
You're kidding?
Yes, of course. But now you respect what we're doing. Andromeda viability and Nexus thresholds are your tools, your reward, and our future. How can I help?
What's the rundown on AVP?
Much of the preparation in the Milky Way was determining how to measure success. Thresholds are about capacity, but this is about cost, what we can actually afford to support. Points aren't the most elegant system, but it makes it clear. The more you earn, the more we can deploy.
How are you measuring thresholds?
It's based on resource estimates and the general stability. A metric of acceptable scope and risk. The more you achieve, the greater capacity we can accommodate, the more the initiative can do for you. Simplest explanation? The more you do, the more room we have to grow.
So I decide what groups to wake up. Won't everyone be out eventually?
Absolutely. But there's an order to things. Lines of support. You can't deploy an omelet without first deploying eggs. And eggs won't get you steak. Except it's people, and how all our lives begin.
There's Y-Spot.
All right, Brekka. Where do I start?
The interface is active and will respond only to a Pathfinder. It's ready for your first selection. You may begin shaping the initiative at your leisure.
All right, so I guess I gotta do this first then. Well, let's take a look at the perks that we get. Earned research point at regular intervals. Selection of minerals. What about drop consumable supplies? Organic materials, tech materials, cognizance, which is hidden caches, 15% more credits. Interesting. Fruit prices, increase inventory. That's actually something that. Go ahead and do mining operations just to get things started. Do I have to do this from here every time though? That would be a little tough. Okay.
Pathfinder, AVP leveling continues as per your directions. And of course, the interface remains accessible for any future adjustments. Sweet protocol and process. Now we're living.
I have a specific person I want brought out of cryo.
Name and designation if available.
That's it? You'll just do it?
Nowhere in my job description does it say, argue with the Pathfinder.
Awesome.
That said, I record all interactions. If something you ask for causes trouble, there'll be no doubt that you're responsible.
That's fine.
Let's keep this between us. Here's the info.
Deployment will begin shortly. Is there anything else, Pathfinder?
Nope.
Another time.
Pathfinder.
Return to Prodromos. Okay, well, I'm gonna do that later then. What else? Oh yeah, let's confront Nilkin. Piece of crap lied to us. Not so innocent as he likes to believe.
Anything to help my case?
An enemy blast to the back killed the chief. Your shot missed.
What? You're kidding me. Thank the spirits. This is great.
Hold on there. The chief's omni-tool recorded you over the body. Sam, play back.
Sorry, old friend. Had to do it. I'm not dying on this rock. Shit.
Not only did you think you killed him, you meant to.
But you just said I didn't, so it doesn't matter, right? The conviction will have to be overturned. The sentence thrown out.
Director Tan will determine what's to be done. You did try to cover it all up.
Look, I'm sorry I lied, but if my shot missed, I'm innocent. Plain and simple.
We'll see about that.
I don't like you very much. Speak with Tan. Alright, let's go talk to Tan.
Pathfinder, do you have just a minute?
Okay.
Ryder, isn't it? Kerry Tvesa, freelance vidmaker. This is Hakim, my producer. I could use your help.
What are you looking for?
Director Tans asked for an uplifting documentary on the initiative. Translation, paint rainbows over our problems. But our problems are history. People deserve the truth, not propaganda.
Alright, looks like, I guess that could have been anybody, I guess.
Maybe a crisis is the time for hope, rather than hard truths.
That was Tan's angle. But if we pretend everything's fine, who does that truly serve? The heart of my documentary will be an interview series. I was hoping you'd take part. I want the dirt and blood of our story, not the convenient fairy tale Tan's looking for. Interested?
He don't mind treading on the initiative director's toes?
What would he do? Pull funding we don't have? I'm game if you are.
Okay, interview away.
Let's start at home. 14 months and the Nexus still isn't finished. Arcs are missing, we have people in exile. By any standard, this wasn't the plan. Our leadership describes these as anticipated issues. Would you agree?
We still have to fix them. Everyone, leaders included, needs to pitch in. Let's be honest about these challenges and how we're going to face them.
Nice. Won't make you popular with the leaders, but it's good to hear. Bandwidth means I'm transmitting in short bursts, so that's all for now. But you can bet I'll have more questions later. You were great. I'll get to work editing.
Is there more?
Hi there.
Nope, guess not.
Hello. Director Tan is expecting you.
Last time I was here, this was a storage closet.
Pathfinder Hall just needed a Pathfinder to open.
We're still getting the commons area ready. Hydroponics is only at partial capacity.
Not good enough.
We don't have enough people. My workers need a break, Tan.
I sympathize, but not until our survival is no longer at risk. Now please excuse me while I meet with our Pathfinder. Hey, Ryder. Addison told me about the outpost. You're the hero of the hour.
Let's hold off on the celebration. We haven't found home yet.
Oh, there's no need for modesty. Success affords leverage over those who doubted you.
And you're my best friend.
A patron. One who shares your vision of a prosperous future.
Due respect, Director Tan, but you don't know me.
Oh, I think I do. Your ingenuity speaks for itself, Ryder. Deciphering the vault, alien terraforming. It's not how we imagined all this, but a good Pathfinder improvises. And a great one hangs it on the wall. Yours are the first trophies to grace Pathfinder Hall. You're a symbol now, Ryder. A reason for people to believe.
It wouldn't have been possible without my crew. They're a talented bunch.
But you're their beacon.
Careful. He'll end up adopting you, Ryder.
Ah, my staff.
Colleagues, you wouldn't be looking to cut us out, would you, Tan?
I remind you, I am the director of the initiative.
Acting director.
This isn't the time for arguing over who gets to be king. Too much is at stake. We should be cooperating.
That's what I've been saying since we arrived.
Then I look forward to winning our Pathfinder support.
I have concerns about your decision on Eos, Ryder. An outpost full of scientists won't do as much good if the Ket attack.
But it will help support the Nexus. Improved research could help feed our people.
And we could argue about it all day long, as we always do. The decision was made. Now we move on. What is your plan for moving on, Ryder?
We have a lead on the terraforming network. I need to take the Tempest deeper into the sector to investigate. If the other Golden Worlds are where they should be, this could get us closer to them.
Careful. The Ket are scouring the cluster for remnant technology. You'll end up in a fight, for sure. You might also run into exiles. They didn't leave the Nexus on good terms.
And we still need more outposts. They're important to expanding the station.
Though with Ark still missing, this could be a chance for Ryder to search for them. Yes, I think that's best. You have my permission.
Thank you, Director. I'll get on it.
May you light the torch that finds the path. Pathfinder. Ugh.
Right.
I don't like Tan, like, whatsoever. There's Cora.
Ryder, This is Harry, back on the Ark.
Go ahead.
We may have found a way to talk to your brother, sort of. Drop by when you can. Hyperion Medbay.
Will do.
Whole mood of the Nexus has changed since
you have EVP outstanding.
You really can feel it. New outpost, a Pathfinder's help, people waking up. It's a fresh start.
Third time's a charm, if you happen to have a Pathfinder around.
Can't always rely on luck. From here, it's hard work. But it's damn good to know we're on the right track.
Alright. Did Sam say I have?
Here, to think about it.
Ryder, you're off to a promising start. I meant what I said. You are a symbol now of hope that things will get better. Though I worry about this terraforming network. What do we really know about it?
It's like nothing we've ever seen. It's clear somebody had big plans for this cluster.
But who?
Not sure yet, but at least we're on the trail.
Did you have some other business?
Director, I checked out that murder. Nilkin didn't do it, but there's proof that he meant to.
This is unfortunate. We're trying to give the people a sense of stability, leadership they think they can count on. And we're setting precedent for justice here in Andromeda. Now this, a convicted murderer who didn't commit the murder.
These things are almost never black and white.
I know. If we suppress the evidence and uphold the conviction, we're banishing a man for a crime he technically didn't commit. If we throw the conviction out, we're freeing a man who tried to take matters into his own hands, then covered it up. Your investigation complicated this. You should take responsibility for the outcome. Do we still exile him for murder?
Honestly, I mean, technically he didn't do it, so...
It was crazy down there. Life and death. But his shot didn't kill Reynolds. We have to let him go.
You're a bottom line type of person. I hope we don't regret it. All right, so be it. He will do community service for his role in the chaos. But he's a free man. Well, at least we'll have this sordid business behind us.
Cool. Let's level up. I got 12 points off that. I probably got 12 points off something else, but that's besides the point. Radius. Now let's do damage and force. Tech. Recharge speed or damage. Let's go ahead and bring down the recharge speed just a little bit. And then... Ah, crap. There. Cool. Alright. Let's level all these guys up. Level 6 for Korra. Or not level 6, but 6 points for Korra. Drax got 16 points. PB. Yeah. we go. Alright, now let's check the journal. Let's go see our brother, I guess.
So the Rensis case is finally closed. I can't believe I'm already covering a murder.
Alright, I don't know what that was, but... It's head to the cryo bay.
Pathfinder, today has not been a good day.
Where's that?
A large shipment of medical supplies intended for Prodromus was intercepted by those damned exiles. Scouts confirmed they've divvied the supplies up among their own outposts.
I'll see what I can do about reclaiming them.
That would be great. Thanks. Maybe when you come across them assholes, you can rectify all this.
Harry, what's happening with Scott?
Well, we got him out of the pod. I don't want to get your hopes up, but Sam managed to, find him, you might say.
I don't follow.
Well, he's still in a coma, but he also has an implant like yours, and Sam managed to access it. He's made contact.
That's incredible. He's okay?
Vitals are steady. But I'm letting Sam take the lead on this one.
Though in a coma, Scott's mental processes remain intact.
So is he okay?
You can ask him yourself. A moment while I establish a link with his implant. Proceed.
Scott? Can you hear me?
Is that you, Sarah? I don't understand. What's happening?
There was a problem with your stasis pod. You're in a coma, on the Hyperion. Do you understand?
Wow, really? How are we talking?
Sam linked into your implant, but they say you're stable. You're safe and sound in the medbay.
Guess I'll take your word for it. I can't feel anything, but I still hear you. Is that okay?
Oh, man.
He's away on a mission right now. I know he's worried about you, though.
Yeah, sure he is. I probably just lost luggage to him by now.
You're wrong. He cares.
Well, at least he's barking orders at you and not me.
Yeah.
So, how's your new home? Does Habitat 7 live up to the hype?
I'll give him the truth on this one.
There's been some complications. Golden Worlds didn't exactly deliver.
Well, that's rough. But we knew it could happen. That's why we brought Dad, right? Find us a place to live?
He's on it.
Damn, I need to be there helping you guys.
You were never one to quit, little brother. A nap won't hold you back.
Someone has to keep an eye on Dad. He doesn't mind snow. No way I'm living on some North Pole.
I'm sure we can arrange for a desert.
Tell Dad.
What happened?
The connection was only temporary. His condition remains stable.
Oh, man.
Sorry, it seemed better than nothing. I'll keep you posted, promise.
Thanks, Harry.
I guess it kind of makes sense, using Sam to be able to talk even though he's in a coma. I don't know. I feel bad about lying to him, though. Sorry. Sorry, Scott. Alright. So I gotta figure out, okay. The Oneon system? I hope I'm saying that right. Alright. Well, I guess it's time to head to the docking bay. Jeez.
Authorities continue work to establish contact with our Milky Way descendant. As of now, beacons confirming arrival in Helios remain unanswered. This is HNS.
Yeah, I mean, that's 2.something million light years. It's going to be pretty difficult for them to get to you. To the Tempest. Man, it does look awesome though.
Koro wanted to check in with you.
I figured there'd be some more conversations to have.
I saw pictures of the vault. Astounding how big it is. And how much of it didn't you see? What if it's way bigger? What's all that space for?
With what it has to do, it could go thousands of miles below the surface of the planet.
Or completely span it. An underground network. Just a thought, of course. I wouldn't even know where to start hypothesizing how it all works. The Remnant Builders, whoever, whatever they were, accomplished something far beyond us.
Well, that's been... I mean...
I should get back to things.
Sounds good?
Sounds kind of familiar. Sounds like the Protheans.
Hello, Gil. When are you cleaning up that repair on the sensor console?
I'm not. It's a redesign.
A redesign? Without a trained crew?
I'm trained, and it's working great. Don't be so uptight.
Everything okay?
Oh, fine. Fine. Don't worry about it.
Okay. Let's see here. Yeah, we got Korra there, Lexi there, Drak there, and Gil there. Okay. Wrong way. Oops. Sorry. I forgot your name, pal. Sorry.
Just how long were you on Helios, Drak?
Long enough to get sand in cracks I didn't even know I had.
And neglect your prosthetics.
Neglect adds character.
Okay.
Report from the Nexus. Population's growing as people wake up. Lots of hopefuls waiting for a home.
Bradley will have all the help he can take.
They'll be starting crops soon. Can't tell if they have enough water or too much. I grew up on a little cargo freighter. Only saw gardens in vids. But I always loved them. I daydreamed about planting a big rose garden when we got here and... still imagine it sometimes. Roses in Helios.
It'd be good to bring something beautiful across galaxies.
Everyone in the Initiative has their something beautiful. I didn't for a while. After I left the Asari Commandos, well, I didn't leave. My mentor, Nasira, said I should go. Why?
I should go.
The Initiative would suit you better, was all she said. Being a huntress suited me fine, but she insisted.
It sounds like she cared more about what you needed than about what you wanted.
I didn't need to be rejected. Still, that's familiar. When your biotics are honed into huntress-grade weapons, people can be weird about it. The Initiative seemed better. Just didn't see how I'd fit into their brave new galaxy. I never fit anywhere before. Then I met some jerk named Ryder. Talked about traveling to Andromeda like he was teaching you how to see it.
What part of that vision made you want to take the plunge?
A civilization where everyone had a place. Even AI. Or an overpowered human biotic. Your father said, I get being different. Now imagine being welcome and making others like you welcome too. When I was 13, I could warp a steel girder. He made me wonder, what if someone had told me, that's okay?
He gave you a dream to work toward. He was good at that.
Who doesn't want to belong? Especially somewhere like the Initiative. So I gave the Initiative my all. Kept thinking of the niche I wanted. My rose garden. I thought I knew what I was going to be.
This is about not taking over as Pathfinder?
Didn't think it would still sting. Nasira, your father, even my parents. They leave, I'm left without answers. Nowhere to stand.
It sucks, but it happened. We need your mind on the mission.
Always is. But I'm human, too. Need time to find a way through. And if that remnant tech pays off, maybe someday I'll have roses, too.
I might have chosen the wrong thing on that last bit, but... She didn't seem to mind too much. Let's talk to... Actually, let's check on the Soul Strike Team thing. Has that been done yet? Cool. Romeo. Alright. Chance of success. Oh, geez. 70%, that's better. 5%. What about this? 70%. I guess I can do this. So...
Strike team ready for deployment.
I assume I'll get more strike teams.
So we have a stowaway.
You mean PB?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
All right.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Just a little conversations for most of these guys.
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for cash ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
Alright.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age, yeah, pretty much.
So he's like the grandpa of the team? Alright, let's see here. We got Gil, and then Peavy. Wait, where did Peavy come from? Let's talk with Gil and PB.
Messing with that vault feels like early brain surgery. Just poking and hoping.
As
long as it helps us to live here, I don't care how the vault's doing it.
Magnificently? That's how.
I prefer tech with more exposed bolts. If you can't open it, you don't own it.
All right.
Long time no chat. What's up?
Oh, well.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
Alright.
You're off the hook, PB. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
You're a stranger.
Forming Atmo processors, gravity wells, life-destroying murder bubbles. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
If we knew what it was all about, it wouldn't be an adventure. It would just be moving, and everyone hates moving. Just the packing alone. Blech.
Point taken. I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
The plan's the same. We find a home. Whatever that takes.
Keep that drive. Makes me believe we can make it. I mean, we have to make it. The alternative is not even worth thinking about.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Prodromos. Prodromos. Sounds good, doesn't it? We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
Okay, well, I guess that's the end of that.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Anyone else down here I need to see? Oh, this is Sam, but... Eos is doing really good. Is there any emails? Oh yeah, there's quite a few. Oh, looks like there's another interview thing. Let's check the journal, see what all we've got going on. Alright, there's also talking to that person. Gotta go back to Pedromos. Oh, Pijack for the Nexus docking base, no way. Speak with Dr. Adriana. Find Spender on the Nexus. Alright, looks like we're sticking on the Nexus for a little bit. I guess we'll... I don't know. We'll figure it out.
Where's my data pad? Oh, how'd you get under there?
Tsuvi, were you talking to your notebook?
Oh, I was, wasn't I? I do that sometimes.
Okay. So there's a few things that I've got to do on the Nexus. Then I'll probably head out to Pedromos and find the and finish up that one little side mission. Maybe see if it's okay to go get that memory fragment too. Looks like there's a couple little markers out here. What we got here? Let's go ahead and start with this, I guess.
Watch your tone. You saw what happened to the Krogan.
But we need this equipment.
Well, you're not getting it. Stop making frivolous requests. Your incompetence isn't my problem. Just do your job.
All right, jackass.
What do you want?
Sounds like you're having a rough day.
You saw that, huh? Oh, I'm sorry I snapped at you. The way Spender treats me? Everyone, I'm just so angry. I don't understand how he's in any position of authority.
He was pretty abusive towards you. Is that normal?
Yes, he's horrible. Working with him is a total nightmare. Just last week, he tried to redirect some of the supplies we need to keep the stasis pods going.
Why?
I have no idea. But if Kesh hadn't stepped in and threatened to airlock him, it would have been a disaster. He's always like that. Making bad decisions, driving the Krogan away, treating people like scum when no one's watching.
You'd think your boss would have the power to do something.
She hates Spender, but there's only one of her, and she can't always be around to deal with him. Things have gotten so bad that Kesh had to literally kick him out of engineering.
How literal are we talking here?
Boot to ass. Oh, it was glorious. We need him gone, but as incompetent as Spender is at his job, he's insanely good at keeping it. Kesh can tell you more.
Guess I'm going to take it to see Kesh. Before I do that, though, let's see what else is on this floor. Oh, I can get my pie jack! I get a pet pie jack! Alright, there's protesters I can talk to. I'll take care of that here in a sec.
Hello there.
Hi. Here we are. One young Pie Jack. Ready to see Andromeda, huh? Sam, can you send a note to Kesh? Make sure our new friend gets delivered to the Tempest.
Acknowledged.
Getting a Pie Jack. Okay. But are these the protesters? Yeah. Looks like there's a few things for me to do.
Seems quiet for now.
Tell our leaders! Wake the sleepers!
I guess Reese is the person to talk to.
Families.
Can I come around here? Thank you.
Hey, what's going on?
That's your new galaxy. Making speeches about some fresh start while your kids stay frozen.
And it's all thanks to your Pathfinder.
Excuse me?
We've waited months for our families to come out of stasis. They should have gone to your outpost.
But since you think research is so important, military personnel got bumped down the list. Like my clan, brothers.
All the reassignments mean they're in 10 different colony blocks now.
And my mother just got caught in the middle.
I founded the outpost. I didn't decide who would stay in stasis.
You don't care that you've torn families apart?
That's not what I said.
Maybe you could still make this right. I just want Mom out of stasis. That's all anyone here wants.
You do stasis revivals. You can tell our leaders you're opening those pods. Today.
I authorize whole colony blocks or a few emergency revivals. I can't wake dozens of random people.
We don't care whose finger pushes the button. If you can't, our leaders can. And if you tell them, they will.
I mean, technically your word is good enough since Chekov. I'm just going to call him Chekov until I remember his name. Just doesn't
okay.
argue with you.
I'll talk to the leadership about what we can do.
14 months of promises. It's time for some results.
We tried petitioning Addison. She ignored us. Screw her.
I'm with you there. Screw
that
Addison.
Tandros. He sent those 10 soldiers over there. Maybe he'll take us seriously.
Alright. I'm with her there, though. Screw Addison. Alright, let's go over to operations, since I think that's where everything is. Kandros and Kesh. And maybe the reporter lady, if she's still up there. I don't know where she's going to be.
Finally.
There we go.
I hear you've been busy out there.
That's one word for it.
Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Ark.
What's the word on the Turian Ark?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive.
We already had this conversation.
Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
I need to talk to you about stasis revival and those protesters in hydroponics.
I see. Maybe I should get the others for this.
Yeah, let's do that.
Protesters have seized hydroponics?
They want their families out of stasis. The outpost on Eos disrupted the schedule. They're scattered across colony blocks. Dozens of people. The protesters want this fixed today.
The realities of our position are...
We can't wake those families. We don't have the resources, and there's nowhere to put them.
We settled Eos. There's no space down there for a few extra.
It's not that simple, Ryder. Everything Eos produces right now is accounted for.
And if we send soldiers to a research outpost, there'll be trouble.
What do you suggest?
Leave the families in stasis where it's safe and get those protesters out of hydroponics. They seem sympathetic, but so did the exiles. We can't risk another revolt. Survival is more important than family reunions.
What would you do with the protesters?
I'd send in a squad and march them out. At gunpoint, if we must. If they resist, a few might land in medbay, but it's better than losing hydroponics. Or the Nexus.
Do you think these protests could turn violent?
We're all pioneers. Even civilians are tough enough to start something.
And interfering in hydroponics threatens our oxygen supply. They know that.
Oh my gosh, why do I have to make these decisions? I mean, both sides freaking have a point here, damn it. Alright, let's end the protests for now. And maybe we can get something done about it when maybe we get one or two more planets able.
We have to look at the bigger picture. Get them out of there.
Kandros?
I'll send in a team, but it might go smoother if Ryder's there.
A good idea. Sometimes we have to give bad news. That's a Pathfinder's duty, too.
Alright, just give it a minute, because I got two more things that I gotta do. Alright, so... poor lady's not over there. Is she up here?
Do you have just a minute? Hi. The documentary's going great. Your comments really got people talking. By the way, Tan called us in for a talk about staying on message.
Is everything okay?
Oh, fine. And much less interesting than what you've been up to. Scientists are excited about your new outpost, though there are questions about how Prodromos can survive where Sites 1 and 2 failed.
I gave Prodromos the best start a Pathfinder could. But we can't predict everything. We just do our best.
Probably not the rah-rah quote Tan would hope for, but very genuine. Facing those risks must be stressful. How do you relax between missions?
My crew and I take downtime together. We're a team.
This is history, too, these little moments between. Shots of this, remnant tech, some narration. That completes an episode. Thanks for stopping.
All right. Waiting on our next one. Let's go talk to Kesh real quick. Oh, hey, Drek. How you doing?
Dell told me you saw her arguing with Spender. Pijak's doing his best to throttle my department.
Hey, I have a
How's
Pijak.
How's he getting away with that?
Spender doesn't know the first thing about engineering, but he knows how to play people. More importantly, he still talks to the exiles. I'm sure of it. I just can't prove it without your help.
Without proof, this will be hard to deal with.
Tell me about it. My grandfather tried to tell Tan. He wouldn't believe him without proof.
Everything I hear about this guy makes me think less of him.
This is my surprised face. Look, I can work with everyday incompetence. But Spender's a traitor and a danger to the station. He needs to be dealt with.
If I have time, I have a lot on my plate.
Think about it. My clan would still be around if it weren't for Spender. Right now, even if they come back, it won't last. Not with him still in the mix.
Okay, so that was the Talk wrong to Canberra. Decision.
He likely has security footage, some kind of evidence. But you'll have to convince him to authorize release.
Nothing more for now.
Try not to die out there.
Okay, so I gotta talk to Candros about that?
A reminder to all personnel, overtime hours
I'll stay back.
Thanks for understanding. About the outpost, and the protesters.
You don't strike me as a political type.
I'm not. Just pro keeping everyone alive.
Right.
Maybe those protesters will eventually understand, too. It's
done. I can talk to them.
I don't want to think about it. Need something else?
I was told I should talk to you about the mutiny.
I wasn't on the Nexus when it happened. I started reading up on it, but you know how things get around here.
Do you know where Spender was during that time?
Why Spender? Wait, you think he might have had something to do with the mutiny?
Maybe. Just trying to sort things out.
You know, the logs I did look through showed a few discrepancies. I meant to dig deeper. If you're investigating, how about I give you access to the security vid archives?
Great.
Thank you.
Anything else?
Nope.
Bye, Candros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
And so the security log is down here. Yeah, it's over here. That's what I figured, but just wanted to make sure.
Huh. This file won't play. Sam, can you boost the quality?
Processing. Playback initiated.
Wait. Is he handing something over to one of the mutineers?
Take this. It'll help you. Don't.
I am sorry, Pathfinder. This backup file is corrupted. The audio tracks are heavily degraded. Someone may have deleted the original, and this version was restored during a system-wide reset.
Sounds like a cover-up to me.
I concur. While I cannot restore any more audio, the location appears to be Kadara.
How do you figure?
In common parlance, lip reading. I do not recognize the location from any current data. It appears mountainous and populated. We will need to find the planet before I can confirm. I will contact you via my node.
Let's go confront Spender.
Alright, so where's Spender at? Is he up here? Yeah, alright.
The mutiny went as well as you'd expect. So much violence. Then, after nearly destroying the station...
Shut up.
Ryder, is it? William Spender. Apologies if we met before. I meet a lot of people running Colonial Affairs.
Running Colonial Affairs? I thought you were the Assistant Director.
That's right. Assistant to Addison. So we know who does all the real work.
From what I've heard, your hands are pretty dirty. I saw the footage. You were handing something off.
What footage? From Gavorkum? Routine business meeting. Whoever you're talking to clearly has an axe to grind. And frankly, a Pathfinder shouldn't be wasting time on a witch hunt. You'd be wise to let this be.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to find that planet. So that's on hold for now, that's fine. protesters now. Alright, so those are some glitchy stairs.
Just stand down, ma'am.
Or you'll shoot me. Good luck explaining that to my grandchildren.
What happened?
She was about to disconnect the water hoses, threaten all the plants.
They're saying the leeches won't wake our families. Well, this is how far we're willing to go. Their move.
I know this is hard, but for the good of the Nexus, we need you to be patient.
We've already waited. How old will I be by the time Mom's out of stasis?
Take it easy, kid. The Pathfinder's got a point.
I'll go off station if I have to. I'll find anyone who'll actually do something.
You want your mom to wake up and find you exiled? Or dead?
Reese, don't. Anything's better than that. Even the longest wait of our lives.
When our families hear about this...
they'll probably agree with the Pathfinder. You're done here. Come on.
Sorry, guys. Still gotta return to Rodromos. Dr. Aradana. Over here somewhere. Up here? Yeah. Tech lab.
Pathfinder Rider.
Hello, Pathfinder. A moment.
What can I do for you, Doctor?
I have a math problem. Some vital equations that only a mind like Sam's could solve. They concern strange transmission patterns in the Scourge. Perhaps random noise, perhaps not.
Sam likes new experiences. It'll be an opportunity to encounter math homework.
Given the complexity and the security implications, I recommend transferring the equations directly into SAM node. I have them on an optical storage disk for you.
I'll see if I have time.
Thank you, Pathfinder. Please thank SAM as well.
Okay. So we're gonna find the other arcs, and they're gonna dock too, I imagine. So what's over here?
What's the trouble?
I've got power shortages throughout the station. I can't for the life of me find the cause. Oh, whoa, you're the Pathfinder. Hey, sorry, please ignore me. You've got way more important things to do.
Power to the Nexus is pretty important. I'm happy to help.
That's great, because I'm at a loss. There are obvious short circuits cropping up all over the place.
Okay.
Pathfinder's eye might reveal something.
Or a scanner.
There's a power short here. We could scan the area.
We invite you to visit our merchants in the Nexus Commons area.
We can start building a bank of vaccines once we get more biomaterial.
Have a look around. We're just getting things up and running. We hope you'll enjoy learning about the rich diversity of people who have arrived from the Milky Way galaxy. Sam should be over here somewhere.
Oh, here. Another power short.
Yeah, looks like it's in the tech lab.
I'm certain, Professor.
There's a side mission over there, too.
Was lost to space during repairs on the Nexus hull. The victim's name has been withheld until next of kin in the Milky Way is notified.
How are you gonna know who the next of kin in the Milky Way is? It's been 600 years. Well, I mean, unless it's an Asari or a Grogan.
Animal did this?
Affirmative. I am able to track it.
Okay, an animal did this. The heck?
Pathfinder, I believe you found the culprit responsible for the power shortages.
Let's capture it. Figure out
what
the
hell it is. Alert Professor Herrick to come secure it.
Level 10! Alright, yeah, let's go ahead and put a little more to the tactical cloak here. Well, you know, I don't really use that enough for it to be that. Maybe a singularity? Yeah, that should work. Aw, man. Same with this guy. Come on. Here we go. And Liam. So, Exile Raid, that's on hold, that's on Dromos, and that's somewhere at Eos or something. Next set. Okay, let's go back to this.
Various parts.
just go to the same node.
Word on completion and remind visitors to avoid affected areas. This is HNS.
Alright. Angry woman.
It's you. You, Pathfinder. I have a word or two for you.
Is there a problem?
Your father is my problem. He's everyone's problem. We're all paying for Alec Ryder's ego. He preyed on Jean Garson's trusting nature and bulldozed us to this godforsaken place. Now she's dead, and we'll all soon follow.
Hey, my dad died for this dream. He was trying to fix things for all of us.
Some dream. He fixed us all right. Go to hell, Pathfinder.
Alright, screw you. Alright, let's talk to Sam.
Welcome back, Sarah.
Dr. Aradana at the tech lab sent some equations for you to solve.
I'm ready.
Transferring them now. Have fun. Hey, what the... Sam?
Malicious code detected. Please stand by.
Sam?
Attempting to countermand malicious code. Please stand by.
Is there anything I can do? Sam? Is that another malfunction, or... Sam? You trying to show me something? Okay, I think I got it. Sam, talk to me.
Hello, Pathfinder. Please initialize the console to restore normal operations.
Sam, what happened?
The equations contained a Trojan horse program, a virus.
What?
Specifically targeted to sever our connection and render me helpless. Reconnecting would be impossible.
You'd need a crack AI programmer to create a virus like that.
Yes. Only my unique adaptions prevented permanent damage.
Unlock the door. Let's head to the tech lab and see what Dr. Aradana has to say.
Yeah, let's do it. Gonna slap her, too. Biotic slap. Somebody's about to get punched in the face.
This scourge, we know it is neither nebula nor H2 region. So
hey.
What is its nature?
Come here.
It's rife with... Welcome, Pathfinder. Did Sam solve the equations I sent?
Solve them? They almost brought down Sam node.
The equations contained a virus designed to target artificial intelligence.
You think I... Never. I abhor violence against any life, organic or synthetic.
Then how did the virus find its way into your equations?
Perhaps my files were altered or replaced. But why?
I've seen a lot of down with AI sentiment lately. Graffiti, complaints to 10. Perhaps someone took the next step.
If graffiti is the best they can do, maybe they could use some artificial intelligence.
Entire species were driven into exile by AI they created, champ. That leaves a mark.
Attacking Sam is bold, though. I wonder if there have been similar incidents.
The AI kiosk was busted this morning.
I can look around.
Pathfinder Ryder, if you will.
All right, well. find out who's trying to kill Sam.
Artificial intelligence is a threat to all organic life. Why not ask for more details? Detecting Pathfinder Rider.
Hi there. Excuse the educational stuff. I hacked a Venus sock puppet. So, our virus set you free. Hope you're doing better without that AI jammed into your head.
Who am I talking to right now?
A friend. Our movement sent the virus to save you.
Pathfinder, it's possible they don't realize their virus failed. Pretending that it worked might win their trust.
Hello? Ryder?
Yes. I can't believe I'm free. Thank you.
This is what our movement is for. Helping people like you. Knight says human AI merging is a threat to all life. She'd know, trust me. Oh, Knight's our founder. The virus wouldn't exist without her.
So where are you running this puppet show from?
Our sanctuary. I'll ask Knight if you can come visit.
Great, thanks.
Can't promise anything, but watch your email. Bye.
Alright, so this one's on hold then.
A whole movement of AI-hating hackers with a leader called Knight.
She and her followers seem to have experience with human AI partnership.
They attacked you, they're capable of anything. I'll check my email. We need to find them.
Those are done. That's on hold. Okay. Alright, and there's supposed to be a mission somewhere around here. Is it back here? Vortex. The Vortex, my bad. Oh, hey, this is the bar. Cool.
That's your flag, everyone. That's for drones.
Hey, I was wondering if you could help me out. It's for the good of the bar.
Lay it on me.
So, folks try and help and all, but we have a limited pool of ingredients. Keep an eye out for anything interesting we could use for new drinks, and we'll let you test them for free.
Right. I get a feeling the testing will be interesting.
Don't worry. Dutch may complain a lot, but he's loving it. And he's the best chemist I know. You're in good hands.
Hyperion Atrium. All right.
It's not the best quality. I found what I was looking for, though. Let's go to the Vortex. Complete this side mission, then we'll head back to the Tempest.
The human Pathfinder has died. Alec Ryder was killed after touching down on Habitat 7 in the Erickson system. Ryder's daughter has reportedly replaced him as Pathfinder, taking command of the Tempest and the ongoing search for a home in Andromeda. This is HNS.
Nice music.
Wow, where did you find those? Never mind, don't answer that. I think they're straight from the Milky Way.
So does that mean
looking
I can test
there.
It? Okay, I guess not. I'm sure though.
Sure that on a valve later. Alright. Let's go back to the Tempest. Doesn't look like there's a way around from that way, so let's go this way. Stop telling me about my dead dad! It's awesome how like it really fully takes off and lands too. Real quick, let me find that side mission. Is that... Oh, there we go.
Ryder.
Let me talk to these guys real quick.
How's it going?
Oh.
I should get back to things. Sirens cage?
Alright, anything interesting from you, Callow?
Oh, the ship manual's useful.
There we go.
That leg of my workbench needed propping up.
If you bothered reading it, you'd know that the Tempest is an orchestra of new tech. You can't just meddle with...
I got this ship launch ready in record time, Callow. I know my stuff.
And you don't have a shred of respect for other people's.
Callow.
Oh, Ryder. Sorry you had to hear that.
Alright, so Callow and Gil are gonna have, are gonna be fun to work with, I think. I want to meet my Padjack. Was it Cora, Lexi,
I'm planning
and
evacuation drills too. Need to start running those.
Padjack!
Whoops! Looks like our Padjack friend got out of his cage. He'll be fine. If you need to won't he? The exercise will probably do him good.
Only if you don't know the drill.
Got a Padjack!
Back again?
How's the search for the Asari Ark going?
The Lucinia? Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
Alright, Drek. Why do I keep saying Drek?
I've seen a lot of shit in my life, but that vault certainly was a first. Things are gonna be interesting with you around, kid.
Doesn't matter what life throws at me. It's what I make of it, right?
You keep that going, you just might live as long as I have. Minus zero at the end.
Now that we've been digging, it's clear you were right about Spender.
Guy like that'll do anything to get ahead. Just wonder how far he went.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Yes?
Oh. Alright, bye.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Anyone else? We got Gil, and then I guess down to the lower floor. Actually, I guess, I mean, don't really need to, since... None of these guys have anything to say. I guess there's really nothing to say from anyone. Let me just climb down this ladder real quick. Krogan thesis, 500 pages. Holy crap. Alrighty then. Looks like we're not getting that email from the AI hackers though, so not yet anyway. I'll be back to check that in a while. Let's go.
Somewhere. Those remnant vaults, all those secrets. Have to go exploring in one someday.
Imagine flying through one. Now that would be a real hazard course.
Cluster map. So wait, this is completely new. Okay. Let's check out Erickson. So are we going to the moon? What are we doing? Okay, nothing on that rock. Hella land. Something.
Mineral deposit.
Alright, cool. Man, yeah, with this scourge in the way, there's no way to jump down to Habitat 7 to make everything cool. Okay, some experience. Yeah. Guess that was it. Wonder if I can at least scan Habitat 7. Try and fly around this scourge stuff. Holy crap, that's gotta be some specific way to fly.
Anomaly on sensors.
Here we go.
Deploying probe. Satellite detected.
Okay. Got some research data. that's it, right? Yep. Picked up everything. So let's check out Pfeiffer.
This is about as far as the Nexus surveyors could get before, well...
Let's see what's waiting here. I'm picking up something. Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Alright, let's go to that first. What is that black hole looking thing over there? Start with this one. This is a little one. All right, nothing to look for. Just one more thing to look at. It's this big scary friggin' thing. And it literally says black hole, so something tells me I'm gonna die when I go up here. Be one of those situations where, like, yeah, I'll do this. Seems interesting. Boom! Smart move, though. Staying far enough away for it doesn't affect you. Alright, let's go back to Eos real quick. Go to Dromos. And, take care of that one mission thing.
Prodromos.
I already knew that. Okay, let's go to Eos real quick. That sound, the little pinging sound effect is awesome. Something you heard quite a bit, I think, in the original Mass Effect. So there are multiple places to land now? Change up my weapons and stuff. Rate of fire is much better. Clip size is much better. Ammo is better. Actually, stone is good. Weight is heavier. Damage is not quite as good. Accuracy. Sorry, I'm trying to get this figured out real quick. Combat fitness. Oh, do I have to freaking... Oh, man. Weight is exactly the same. That's good. Ultralight materials and scope. Space Explorer. What did I get with this? Counter experience, weapon weight, and ammo. Yeah, let's do that. That should be great, actually. Don't have any consumables. Squad. I'll keep it the same for now. I'll use them on the new one. Tabula rasa. Oh. Mind as such. Yeah, let's do it. Okay. Confirm loadout.
The scent is green.
Coordinating. Path is calm.
Alright, well, now that things are cleared up a little bit, maybe I can take a better look into that memory thing as well. I'll take a look. Can't do it because I'm in a settlement. Alright, fine.
Ryder.
Hi.
Pathfinder, Darket, Tervian. I understand I was pulled from cryo ahead of schedule. My family is grateful, but I consider it my debt.
Everyone gets out eventually.
That may be, but the least I can do is show you the benefit. I'm Exo Studies now, but in a former life, let's say I knew tactics. If I supplied the Ket on this planet, I'd drifted in, and there's only so many gravitational paths. Here's some navs to check for anomalies. Good hunting, Pathfinder.
Caches. Alright, real quick, I want to check something. Yeah, combat fitness. Alright, looks like I'm going to have to take care of that a little bit. I can also increase some stuff with my sniper rifles and pistols, too. But power fitness should definitely, or combat fitness should definitely be my next few things. Looks like there's one thing right here. Oh. Let's go ahead and make that our primary mission for now. And, let's get going. So, still some radiation hazard.
Radiation levels have spiked, Pathfinder.
Let's see if I can do this this time around. Oh, I'm nowhere near it, am I?
Outposts and an Ark escape pod. Where'd they get that?
Crap. Do you think they might have found an Ark?
We need an up close scan.
Wonder if there's anything hidden away back here.
Well, can't go back here. That's the end of that, I guess.
Leaving Atmo. All clear.
And there is a system to go to see about. Okay, hang on. Alright, that's fine. Pythias system.
Hello?
Anomaly detected. Deploying probe. I found something.
What's that?
Our Turian friend on Eos has good instincts. Let's check it out.
Anomaly detected. Probes launched. I found something.
Possible Ket supplies, just like Darket suggested.
Okay. Yeah, it looks like that's done. Other than that, there's really not much else to do right now. Yeah, there's not much to do right now, so I guess let's jump into the Onean.
On a collision course with unknown objects.
Make corrections.
Oh,
Sam,
crap.
Are you on this?
Collision is imminent.
All stop now!
Oh.
Ket ships. A dozen. No, more.
They've got us pinned against the Scourge.
They are scanning us, Pathfinder.
We'll scan them back.
Where is the one who activated the remnant? Their DNA signature is there. Answer me.
You're the one in my way. Who are you?
They've lost navigation.
We're being steered into their ship.
Just tell me what you want.
I won't explain what you can't understand.
Ryder, I have almost regained control of the ship. I need a few more seconds.
I actually know a lot about the Remnant. We should compare notes.
Enough! Your defiance is naive and reckless. This day marks the beginning of your greatness.
Sam?
I have plotted a potential course through the Scourge.
Do it! Report!
Enemy destroyed. Damage to aft sensors.
Scourge got it?
Yes.
Get us out of here!
It will be tight.
Callow?
Yes!
Nice work, kid.
Yeah, but who the hell was that guy?
Ryder, we've got trouble down here. You need to find us a port now.
Great. Where'd we end up, anyway?
Sensors are damaged, but I think we're at the vault's coordinates.
You think? Gil, give it what you can. We're setting down.
We're being contacted.
We have to land. Open a comm.
Tov Jagalesto. Tov Jagalesto.
We're visitors from another galaxy. Our intentions are peaceful.
Pav Nalisetto.
They've sent us a nav point.
Set us down.
Okay, that's a pretty stark contrast.
Look at that. It's beautiful.
Oh, wow.
We need in that vault.
Please, you're not really going out there on your own.
We can't afford a repeat of last time. I'm the Pathfinder. First contact is on me.
Most important thing ever. No pressure.
If this goes badly, if I get eaten alive, even if it's hilarious, please destroy the vids.
Okay. Crowd chatter. Yikes.
Need me to take my shoes off?
I'm Paran Shai, governor of Aya. We are the Angara.
Hello. I'm a Pathfinder with the Initiative.
Yes. You crossed Darkspace. I've heard of your journey. Joel, I have this in hand.
Ephra saw this ship come in and sent me to find out what's going on.
She's a human from another galaxy. A Pathfinder.
Aya is hidden. Protected. What do you want?
Our intentions are simple. You'd like to look in your vault, and then we're out of here.
You think that's simple? You don't know anything. I'll inform Ephra. He'll be waiting for you in his office at the Resistance headquarters. I'll meet you there.
I will accompany you through our city. Your crew will stay on your ship. Follow me.
Okay, well, this is going better than it did with the cat. Somewhat. They don't seem to like me very much, though.
Follow closely. Do not try to explore the city or interact with anyone. Ephra's guards will use force if necessary.
Understood. Is it okay to ask...
Yeah, I need to track that, though. Oh, that's part of a completed mission, so it's...
Few questions?
I suppose.
If you're the governor, why do I need to see this Ephra?
He's leader of the Resistance.
What's that?
They fight the Ket and protect us.
That's a human.
What's happening?
We have a
I detect unusual levels of electrostatic energy in the Angara.
At least it's not this is insane. It belongs in a containment cell.
Jeez, calling me it.
You don't know what you're doing.
Am I that intimidating?
You're an outsider who invaded our home. We know nothing about you.
I'm not here to cause trouble.
Then keep moving.
Okay. I understand that kind of hesitation, I guess.
How did it find us?
Gee, not it. And stop staring.
How do they know of humans already, though?
None of the local flora register in my data files. We've encountered an undiscovered ecosystem.
I'll scan it later when I'm not...
The city is beautiful.
Thank you. You're the first outsider to see it.
I'm honored. What happens if Ephra doesn't like me?
He won't. But you need to earn his trust.
He's responsible for everyone's safety. I know what that's like.
You're a leader.
Trying to be.
So, do I just go in? Okay.
They are bullies. But this situation is now your fault. Don't get kicked out, Moran. Not because of them.
But you're telling me to be weak.
No. I am telling you to be strong through your cunning and heart. Okay? Hey.
How do they have translators for them already? I mean, I know
it really is the best one in the Resistance.
I know.
How do they have translators already for species they know nothing about?
Our experience with the Ket makes us naturally distrustful of all aliens.
We're nothing like them. In fact, maybe we can help each other out.
We made that mistake when the Ket arrived. When the Archon came to Helios, he demolished our sovereign state. Took what he wanted, as if we were nothing. Now, the Ket mercilessly abduct Angara, often... We never see our people again. Come this way. Ephra is waiting.
Wait, the Ket kidnap you? Steal your people?
And the Resistance fights them every day. With everything we can.
Is it attrition? What are they after?
You should save your questions for Ephra.
Kadara be damned. I won't lose Vold. Ephra, this is one of the aliens from the Milky Way. A Pathfinder.
Pathfinder. It's an aggressive move coming to Aya.
It wasn't meant that way. I have an Ark full of desperate people counting on me to find them a home before they starve.
Of course, I feel for you and your people. So, Pathfinder, never mind how you even found us. Why are you here?
On a hostile planet we call Eos, I explored an ancient structure, a vault. And brought it back online. It stabilized that planet's environment.
Remnant. Recent intelligence supports that claim.
If I'm right, there's a vault on Aya that's different. I need to look inside.
You're right. There's a vault out there, but it was shut years ago and the entrance hidden. We can't help you.
The Moshai could. She's our most revered scientist and elder. She knows this vault.
But now the Ket have her, and our rescue attempts failed. She's lost to us, and you.
There must be another way. How can I convince you? Can I offer help?
Arrogant. I don't know you, let alone trust you. Why would I want your help?
Of course.
Ephra, I feel... Ephra, what this alien says is extraordinary. The Moshai would want us to be brave and not let this chance pass.
Joel, you talk too much.
Let me assess this alien. I'll be your eyes. I know you can spare me.
Go if you want, but when she tries to kill you, be prepared to strike first.
Jeez. I'm Jarl Amadarav. I'll be your envoy through Angaran space.
Thank you for trusting me.
I don't. But I can always kill you in your sleep.
Good to
okay.
know.
First steps.
I've organized my analysis of Aya.
Alright, so I guess Gil had something to say, probably about the this being okay.
I'm just saying, as far as first contact goes, at least that went better than the last one.
Only slightly.
Yeah, what happened? I wanted to look around.
And now we have another mouth to feed, whatever he eats.
Did the translators not work?
They work.
Come on, everyone. Can we just all please try to... just listen up?
Begging. Interesting strategy.
Ryder, we followed our best lead here, and now we don't even have that. Jahl has offered to do what he can to help us access the vault on Aya.
How do we do that when we're leaving the planet it's on?
That's... a fair point. Jahl?
Seriously.
Settle down. Ryder's right. There's an Angara right here. Let's hear from the new guy.
One day, about 80 years ago, the Archon and the Ket arrived in Helios, and the horror began.
They declared war?
Nothing so easy to define or fight.
The Ket kidnap Angara. Their people disappear without a trace. What if they were us?
Sure, I'll fight Ket all day long, but that's no plan.
I agree. We need to get into that vault, Ryder. Surprisingly, I'm with PB. Our own mission has to take priority. We have a plan. Kind of. Pretty solid. Jahl?
The resistance is stretched thin. I was tasked with traveling to two of our worlds at our briefing this morning. And you'll accompany me.
Because?
Because then, Ephra will see you as trustworthy. You want that.
Jahl's told me about these two worlds, Havarl and Vold.
Before the Scourge disaster, Vold was a thriving planet of billions, a shining center of technology and life.
And now?
It's the center of our ground war against the Ket. Our resistance base is fighting Ket Command for control of the planet.
What about the other?
Havarl? Is the birthplace of the Angara. It's started to degrade, to become wild and dangerous. We suspect Remnant.
Now we're talking.
We've recently lost contact with our scientists.
Still don't get how any of this helps us.
I do. Help us, or rather help me, and I'll vouch for you, right? Because Jahl wants inside Aya's vault, too.
Pathfinder, it's your call.
Okay. Yes. I appreciate the vote of confidence.
Maybe more like optimism. Confidence? You'll get there.
Jahl, give Kello the nav points for both planets. Let's do this.
Full roster. Don't really have a choice but to have full roster on this one, do we? Alright. So I'm going downstairs real quick. Before I do anything.
Still compiling my first impressions. But even their body language is so emotional. I can't.
I can try talking to him for you.
That's kind, Subi. But I don't think it will help.
We might have a problem. I was running some numbers, mass balances and such. The Tempest is carrying about 70 kilos of extra mass. I think something's aboard that doesn't belong.
70 kilos is enough mass for another person.
Our internal sensors aren't getting anything, but they're not as powerful as a Pathfinder's scanner. Can you take a look?
All right. I'll look around the ship and see what I can find.
Alright.
Sam's been compiling our star charts. The other pilots on the Nexus will have plenty of new trails to follow.
You can drop the charts off the next time we're there.
Funny. A few months ago, that station was like a war zone. Flying was my only way to escape the chaos. Now it's become a haven, just as it was meant to be.
Everyone's really working to get the Nexus on its feet.
Regardless, the worst threat to the whole initiative is still that monstrosity.
You mean the Scourge?
I still see it crippling the Nexus in my memories. I had to train other pilots in hazardous flight techniques just to look for food and water. It's a cage that eats good ships and good people. Helios won't be home so long as it's a threat.
It's a huge space anomaly. It's not going away in anyone's lifetime.
If we could somehow neutralize it, or if our ships had defenses against it. Still, that's what we do, isn't it? Find a way where there is none. Just see the Nexus for proof of that.
So, Jahl.
So?
We haven't had a chance to talk alone. You comfortable in here?
I took it. It feels strange to stay with the others. They are... you are... aliens.
And you're alien to us, so... there. We have something in common.
We can look at it as a... place to start?
Got it.
Perhaps then... if we're all aliens, it's about what kind of alien we are.
You had no idea about us, but you signed up to help us anyway.
Perhaps it had nothing to do with you.
Care to elaborate?
I do not.
Okay.
How do you know Moshe Sepha?
She's our greatest mind on the Remnant. I was her student.
You studied the Remnant, too?
A little. I was terrible. I quit. Or she threw me out. One of those. We're still very close.
So, is that your rifle?
It is now. It's Ket. With my own modifications. I like to tinker, to get my hands on something and take it apart.
That's a skill I know we can use, but I have one request. Please don't take apart my ship.
You're right. I signed up, volunteered for this. It's exciting. There's something unique about you. Uneasy, raw, but somehow profound.
Face value? That sounds like a compliment. A nice one.
It is. Angara feel deeply. We have more trouble hiding our emotions than showing them. I should get back to my work.
As if I didn't have enough on my plate? Add deciphering alien psychology.
What plate?
Exactly. See you later. None of the equipment in here would produce extra mass readings.
One hell of a trip this is turning out to be. Hostiles, ruined worlds, no home in sight. Everyone's getting toasty. There was a 2-hour argument yesterday, and no one even knew how it started.
That's not good.
Luckily, I have the perfect way for people to unwind. Movie night.
Taking a breather for a good movie? I could get behind that.
Best part is, it doesn't need to be good. Still get mileage out of the bad ones. It's worth it to jumpstart everyone's pioneer spirit and all that. The Tempest database is pretty dry. Could you download a movie library from Nexus Ops to see what I've got to work with?
5 times.
Thanks. Everyone will appreciate it.
Alright, that's gonna be... yeah. Alright. Real quick... Looks like Lexi is the only one left, so. Anything else in here?
Need something?
Guess not.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Alright, so let me scan that. Try and do it from the bridge. There we go.
No extra mass in the airlock. Too bad. It'd be easy to get rid of it.
Ah, there you are. Gotcha.
Am I interrupting?
Nope. I go the way the wind blows. You're here now, so you're the wind. Just dealing with some scourge issues. That Archon fella tried to warn you not to joyride into it, but you were just la la la. It was an act first, think later move. I respect it. Well, more like I resemble it. Hey, you play poker?
Come again?
Poker. Card game, bluffing, betting. It's an age-old measuring stick of a person's character, fortitude, guts. Used to think maybe it was my calling. Turns out I'm just good at it. Never lost heads up. We should play sometime.
Willing to put your streak on the line?
Huh. I'll risk it. Next time we port up and you're in the mood, I'm always in the mood.
Alright. Hey, baby. Let me scan real quick, see if I can...
All the mass readings in here are normal.
Of course they are. Something up.
I hope...
I did not like the look of that Archon. Maybe the Angara will let me pitch a 10 on Aya for the duration.
Didn't think you were the type to run from trouble.
Well, when you put it that way. All right. Next time, keep him on the line. I might have something to say.
All right.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
You know it.
Oh, whoops.
Got it. Suvi, that extra mass is behind the storage room bulkhead.
Behind it?
It looks like a construction mech welded right into the hull.
Scanning the parts has activated an audio log.
I think I know what that's about, Ryder. Come up to the bridge.
Alright, let's talk to Cora real quick.
That Archon. Arrogant son of a bitch. Maybe that's redundant for a Ket.
He's also the first Ket who bothered to talk to us. That's useful intel.
True. They can communicate. They just prefer to open fire. So, what else is new?
That's about it.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
Track Vetra, and I'm gonna need to go up and talk to Callow.
Your take on the Angara, old man?
Strong, honorable survivors. Been a while since I encountered a new friendly species. Last time was the humans.
Oh yeah, you lived through first contact with them, didn't you?
If I recall, my exact words were, they're bold for being so squishy, do they know they're mostly water?
Harsh. Don't let Ryder hear you.
I just did.
Pathfinder.
Oh, I guess that's it. Okay.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
How about you, Vetra? You got anything?
Hey, Ryder.
Guess not.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Okay. Let's talk, buddy.
Those parts you found welded in the storage room. I recognize them.
From where?
They belong to the ship's lead designer, Lucille Diawara. She broke her back during construction. But Lucille wouldn't abandon her ship. She converted a construction mech into a rig she could wear. She must have welded it into the hull. Her artist's signature.
600 years later, the power's run out. Suvi detects it.
Sam, didn't you find an audio log with Lucille's rig? Can you play it?
Sam found my construction gear then. Well done. One of you Pathfinders got the Tempest. Mason Barrow, Zevin Reka, Matriarch Ishara, Alec Ryder. You were the best of us.
Dad's gone. Makes you wonder how many other Pathfinders made it.
We'll find out. It's what you do.
Take care of my ship and each other. Whatever is in Andromeda, you're the Milky Way to them. We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with a sleep.
I never thought I'd hear Lucille's voice again.
She really cared about the Pathfinders. Enough to give them her rig. For luck.
Lucille made it a part of the Tempest. Let's keep it that way.
I'll see to it, Ryder.
Thanks. Now let's go make her proud.
Alright. Innocent enough. Oh, and I reached level 11. That's gonna be it for this part, guys. I'll pick this back up next time I'm able. Might be tomorrow night, might be sometime later, I'm not sure. But thank you to everybody who watched this on YouTube, and I think that's pretty much gonna be it. Alright, well, this is the one and only Maverick signing off.